cultivate a far-sighted perspective. It seems that wisdom comes when it is too late. It only comes in hindsight, when we look back at our mistakes, at our faults, at the things that other people did and we did not. To cultivate a far-sighted perspective, we need to expand our view in the present moment. We need to climb the mountain. We need to step back and just consider perspectives. Ready?
就是说我们要培养一个长远的目光吧，怎么说，就是我们要学会从现在的这个，就是现在的时刻去扩展我们的目光，然后去看就是别人做到了什么，然后我们没有做到什么，然后就要以此来。 反省一下自己，然后去看一下过去犯下的错误，然后就把它运用到就是我们以后要怎么做上面。
How do we cultivate far-sighted perspective? The first way is to get distance from the present. How do we do this? We have to detach from the heat of the moment. Remember that we are emotional creatures. And when we are emotional, it is very difficult to see far-sighted. It's very difficult to see into the future. It's very difficult to consider other options, to think about the past. The only way to get distance from the present is to calm our emotions. When we are excited or angry or fearful, we will make poor, short-sighted decisions. Now, how do you detach from the present moment? There are several ways. The way that I always recommend is through mindfulness. Mindfulness allows you to disconnect, especially to calm your emotions so that your rationality reappears, so that your ability to think, your ability to give yourself time to think occurs. There are other ways too. You can physically remove yourself from the situation. Distancing yourself from the present moment does not have to be by going somewhere in your head. You could leave the room. You could say, hey, you know what? I'll call you back. You could decide not to reply to a message that makes you angry in that present moment. This allows you to cultivate a far-sighted perspective and make better decisions. Betty?
就是要怎么去培养一个长远的目光，就是有一个办法，就是从现状中分离出来，怎么说，就要怎么做到它，就是人都是情感的生物嘛，就是当我们处于自己的感情中的时候，我们往往不能从现状中 想到另一种选择，或者是做法，就是往往就是用着自己的感情走，然后就选比较导致比较差的结果的做法。然后这个时候我们就需要把自己冷静下来，然后就是先不要纠结这一件事情，先把自己的想法去转向别的地方去，然后再回来再想这件事情，就当你冷静下来之后，才能比较理智的看待它，从而有更长远的判断。 然后还有一个方法就是物理上的移动自己，就比如说在房间里面走来走去这样子，或者是出一趟门，就让自己走动一下，然后以此来让自己转移注意力之类的吧，就这样。
Look deeper at the source of the problems. This is extremely important. A problem itself occurs. We see the problem. We have that initial response. And in that moment, we make a decision. But often there are going to be unexpected consequences because we did not consider the source of the problem. We did not look deeper at the problem itself. We did not consider why the problem occurred, who are the people responsible for the creation of that situation. We need to find more explanations. We need to find and compare the explanations of the problem to get a better understanding. Get a wider perspective. We have to consider the motivations of the people involved. We have to imagine negative consequences to any of our actions or decisions. We have to look at the other possibilities that might occur based on whatever decision we're going to make. We have to consider opportunities. We have to consider different strategies for dealing with a problem once we have looked at it deeper and found its real source or sources. We can look into the future. We can look at what are some things that may occur after this problem has occurred. We can look at the past. We can learn from our lessons. We can learn from the things that we have already experienced that might be similar to this. Betty?
要如何去培养长远的目光，还有就是要深入的看待这个问题，然后找到这个问题的那个源头是出在哪里，就比如说是什么导致这件事情发生，然后谁应该对这件事情负责，这样子。然后同时我们也要有比较，怎么说，比较多方位的去看待这个问题吧。就怎么说，如果我这样子做了的话，会导致什么样的后果，就是可能会有什么不好的后果，然后如果我不这样做的话又会有什么后果，就是要想多一些这件事情的可能性，因为毕竟不是说你感觉它会怎么样就会怎么样的，然后就是要看将来会发生的事情，就比如说这件事情可能导致什么样的后果，然后这些后果又会造成什么，就是要有这样一个逻辑的思维，然后也可以借鉴过去的经验，就是在之前有没有发生过类似的事情，然后可以给我们参考去推断这件事该怎么处理，或者会怎么演，会怎么继续发生这样。I finished both.
An example here of looking deeper at the source of the problems. The shoulder and the knee. So a man goes to the doctor and says, "Doctor, my shoulder hurts." Now the way that the doctor can deal with this is to deal with the initial problem of the shoulder, to give the man some medicine or to put some ice on the shoulder, to treat the shoulder itself. But the doctor decides to do an x-ray of the man and finds that yes, there is a problem with the shoulder, but the source of the problem is not necessarily the shoulder. The shoulder has a problem because the man's knee aches. And so when the man walks, he does not walk straight. He puts more of his weight on one side of his body and he uses the shoulder there to help him to stand up straight. He uses the shoulder more, and this causes an imbalance in his body. So not only is the shoulder a problem, the source of the problem is actually the knee. And so the doctor has to not just treat the shoulder, but focus on solving the source of the problem, which is treating the knee. The doctor would never have been able to do this without a wider perspective, without treating thousands and thousands of patients and understanding that most of these problems are caused by deeper issues. If he or she was a new doctor, he may not have looked at the source of the problem, and he or she may have just treated the shoulder and completely ignored the knee. The problem would never have disappeared. That would have been a short-sighted treatment of the problem. But what the doctor did was use perspective, use his or her experience to understand that it has to be caused by something else and find what is causing the problem in the shoulder to get rid of the problem permanently. Betty.
就是举个例子，就是有一个男的他来看病，然后跟医生说他的肩膀很痛，然后就感觉肩膀受伤了。然后如果是一般来说，就我们可能会第一时间就想，那就给他开治肩膀的药，然后帮他冰敷一下肩膀啊，就是对症下药嘛，就是把他肩膀治好就算了。就是但是这个医生呢，他就是平常之前从你的经验中看出来，这个男的他肩膀痛其实是因为他的膝盖不好，然后膝盖不好，当他在走路的时候就可能会用他的肩膀去，他是摔了，就是他的肩膀啊，不，他的膝盖不好，因为总是骨折，他就是靠一边来走路，然后肩膀就是保持平衡。
对，
就是他，因为他膝盖不好，就是走路就会一瘸一拐的。然后为了保持平衡的话，他就需要用他的肩膀来保持平衡。然后这样的话，他肩膀就受力不均了，这样就会导致他肩膀痛。然后如果只是治肩膀不治他的膝盖的话，就是他下次还会继续这样子来治肩膀，就是这个问题永远得不到解决，是因为一般的医生的话他看不到他本来是因为什么发生的，但这个医生他就看出来他是因为膝盖不好，然后才连锁反应的导致了他肩膀的问题，就给他治了膝盖。然后他就因为他用了他比较长远的目光，就是他因为之前已经治愈过很多案例，他有这样的经验，然后他从过去的经验中知道他肯定不是单纯的肩膀疼，他有更深层次的原因。 I finish。 Bob, I finish。
So at the end, the final conclusion of this law of short-sightedness is that we all have problems disconnecting from the present moment and looking into the future. The way to deal with this always is to try to slow time down. In these moments, the more time that we can give ourselves, the more chance we have of making better decisions, of making decisions that are not short-sighted. We have more perspective, we can consider the past, the future, and it allows us to make better decisions. We can consider our long-term goals. It's very important when it comes to short-sighted decisions, very important when it comes to reducing short-sighted decisions, making more far-sighted decisions, to always consider our long-term goals and put them into perspective. Remember, by climbing up the side of that mountain, you always see much more. By getting to the top of the mountain, it takes time to get there, but by getting to the top of the mountain, you are able to see everything more clearly. You are able to make more far-sighted decisions. Betty.
我们都会有这种目光短浅的问题，就是当我们在处理问题的时候，就总会，就是总是会难以把将来，哎呦，就是总是难以把后果和我们现在做的决定联系起来，然后我们就要学会，当我们做，解决问题、做决定的时候，要学会先稍微放慢一点，给自己更多的时间去考虑。去考虑这个问题，然后才能做出更好的决定。就是要有长远的目光去看待问题。然后这个练习其实就像爬山，就像爬山一样的，就是一开始你做的时候可能会感觉很辛苦，因为你一下要处理太多的信息。但是，一旦你爬到山顶的时候，你会发现你就有了这个能力去纵观全局，就会有个就会怎么说？对自己的发展就更有益吧，就是我们要永远保持长远的目光，然后我们要考虑到这件事情对我们长期的发展做出所有的影响。I finish.
Alright, guys, thank you very much.